is me at Hermit Cave in Griffith. Hi everybody, it's a bit warm today. I just thought I would say a quick hi. I'm just thinking about the themes that I want to talk about ahead of today. I'm not going to be able to do any daily vlogs for a while, so certainly not over the next few weeks anyway, but I will keep you informed of what's going on, and I will talk in depth more about the soul numerology, more about the awakening and the awakened, because that really is a vital part of everything that is happening at the minute. We are all being awakened. This awakening is what is really important at this moment in time. The sun is going through a lot of changes, a lot of our alterations, and a lot of vibrational upliftments and upliftings which are affecting the planet at this time. So it is really important that I do talk about awakening at the moment and how it's going to affect you and you and you. It is going to affect everybody. So my plan is to introduce my viewpoint, my ideas from my level, from I want to introduce my ideas from my point of view, from my experiences, and I want to pass it on to you guys, just for you to just think. I'm not forcing anything on anybody. So until we next meet,
so
take
I'm
care. A little bit different than everybody else. Well, I say absolutely awesome to that. I am different. I'm unique. I do things my own way. I'm not stereotyped. I'm not a sheep. I don't follow the conformity of everybody else. I don't do exactly the same thing as everybody else. And I do have people following me in my wake, in my shadow, because I'm obviously doing something right. And I think I'm doing something right in that I do try to remain true to myself. And I do try to do things that are unique and inimitable to myself, a little bit different. I work a little bit differently than everybody else in that I'm as much as I can be self-trained. I'm not impressed by, or I've not had impressed on me, the viewpoints or the techniques that others have put out there in the New Age arena. I tend to, when I've used my rune cards and my tarot cards and my numerology and the way that I connect, I've tended to find out myself and experiment myself over the years rather than go to classes and be given ideas. I tend to do it my own way. Okay, so initially I went to a development group in the UK in the 80s, but it doesn't mean that I actually did what I was told there. No, my late mentor Paula would have told you that I was one of her most awkward students, and that I would do it my own way even then back when I was in my late teens, early 20s. I had my own mindset. I had my own way of doing things even then. And why change? Why go to development groups? Why I've been asked to join development groups and go to development groups and go to people's workshops. Why do I need to go to anybody else's when my own style works? It works for me. It works perfectly for me. I studied psychology and parapsychology, and I came to understand the mechanism of what it's all about. I sort of unlocked the keys as to why and how, and really it's gone on from there. Now, guides. Do I believe in guides? Not really. I certainly don't believe in the elusive they telling me this and they're telling me that, or my guide is saying this and my guide is talking to your guide and your guide is telling this. I don't believe any of that. But I do believe that I've got friends and family on the other side, because I've got at least eight, nine friends who were mediums and healers in their own way, who are on the other side. Plus I have my father, who is a very, very impressive communicator. So I don't need the elusive guides, but I do believe I have assistance from the other side. Now, how do I think the other side is going to work? Now, that is for another video. How do I think that the other side works? How do I think the other side connects with us? That is for another video, that is for another time. But I will say to you, it is not how the market, the arena, the New Age arena, the psychic medium arena portrays it. They do not work with they are telling me this. But I just really wanted to just keep in touch with you guys, in touch with everybody. and really just film at a different location. And this place is absolutely stunning. If anyone's been to Hermit's Cave in New South Wales, they will know what I'm talking about. And anybody who wishes to go to a fantastic sandstone landscape, come to Hermit's Cave. It's on Scenic Drive in Griffith, and it is incredible. It's an incredible place. And I've come for a little bit of clicky-clicky birdie photography. And I must admit, I'm not doing particularly well at the moment. It's probably the wrong time of the day. What is it? It's probably about 4:15 in the afternoon at the minute. And it is hot. I have got a sweat on, as I've mentioned. So I'm just going to leave it at that moment. I'm just going to leave you with a thought. Don't actually take anything for granted. Things can change just like that. What you take for granted can go, be taken away from you just like that. What seems normal and part of your routine in your life yesterday can actually change the very next morning. And I've actually found that out today. And it came as a little bit of a shock. So all I'm going to say to people is shocks to the system are what happen when your soul or the universe wishes you, when the universe wishes you to grow. I got mumbled then. And always remember, the cosmos is always watching you. It is always watching you. With that thought, take care.